Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to another evening of Hiller Volleyball. This is Steve Sweetapple along with Mike Tarosian, and it's Friday, October 14th. The Hopkinton Hillers are welcoming the Bellingham Blackhawks to the fieldhouse on the annual Dig Pink Night.
Yeah, do not adjust your sets, folks. This is the color. Everyone's in pink tonight, including us handsome broadcasters.
We are resplendent in our pink.
Yeah, we're here tonight. This big fundraiser. This is our sixth year doing it.
Yep.
And they raised thousands of dollars for the Seidel Foundation, which supports cancer research and education.
Yep. So between, I think it's the second and third set, there's a raffle of many different gift baskets that'll be done.
And an awesome bicycle that everyone's shooting for.
I want the pink bike.
We all want the bike. All right, so we're going to take it down to the public address announcer, Chip Collins.
And HKM says it's over to me, live from Hopkin High School. Good evening and welcome to Hopkin High School for tonight's volleyball match against your very own Hopkin Hillers and the Blackhawks of Bellingham. It is our annual Dig Pink here at Hopkinton. The annual Dig Pink event brings together volleyball players across the nation to raise funds for breast cancer research, demonstrate the power of teamwork, and show support for people with this disease. All of us have been impacted by the devastating effects of cancer, so we would like to sincerely thank everyone for their support in this very important cause. Last year's event was a great success for the Hillers, to raise even more funds this year for the Seidel Foundation. We believe that education is a key and interesting knowledge about breast cancer and that raising the essential to support further research. The funds to raise for the Seidel goes towards critical trial significant, specifically for patients with stage 4 breast cancer, the most advanced form of breast cancer in the least funded area of this research. And now for our national anthem, be sung by Alexa Benak.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Fantastic. Good luck, ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, just so you remember, there were some baskets and some raffles out here. We need to sell as much as we can. We're going to raise as much money as time to sign our foundation. So let's bring it in strong. Back to you, HKM.
Great segue from Chip there. And what a fantastic rendition of the national anthem.
Yeah, JV volleyball player, Alexa Benak.
So Bellingham comes in with a 2-11 record overall, 1-11. In the Tri-Valley League, and the Hillers come in with an 11-1 overall record, 10-0 undefeated in the Tri-Valley League, sitting atop the league. The Hillers are coming off a 3-0 sweep of Holliston last week. And Bellingham is coming off a loss to Westwood. Out there on the floor for the Hillers, up at the net, we've got Michaela, Amanda, and Ivy in the back row of Jill, Allison, and Courtney, with Jess getting ready to check in as the libero, wearing the black shirt tonight.
And for Bellingham, let's see if I get this right. Jenna Venuti, Maddie Madigani. Looks like Casey Baker, Amy Colho, Gabby Pelizanuos, and Mackenzie Butcher, which I should have studied these and asked some of the JV players before the game started.
And the girls are wearing new Dig Pink shirts this year.
Yeah, they decided to change them up a little bit. Wasn't sure if they were going to go with the names on the back or not, but she just, obviously we see that she did not, so that means we might see these again next year.
I like these shirts.
I like these ones here. A lot more stylish than the JV. I thought the JV version was great. Because remember when they all started, it was just basic T-shirts.
Right.
But the more and more that these fundraiser games come about, the uniform companies are now making these pink jerseys.
Okay, and I think the referees have approved the, checked out the rotations.
Yeah, it looks like everyone's in line. And I don't know if the folks at home will notice when we go wide, you'll see something missing at the top of your screen.
Yep.
The big monster scoreboard that was the centerpiece of the Athletic Center since the school opened in 2001 was taken down on Columbus Day.
And Casey Baker gets us underway. Nice deep serve. Hopkinton had a little trouble receiving it, but they kept it in play. Courtney with an outside set, two hands. Point to Bellingham. Yeah, the field house looks so much bigger from up here when you don't see that ginormous.
And now we have a lot more light, too, in the center of the court. And you don't see the big shadow being casted.
Miscommunication there between Allison and Ivy. Should have been Allison's ball all the way.
Allison with the off-balance twist. Unable to get both hands on it.
And that sails long. Side out to the Hillers.
Yeah, that was ripped long by Casey Baker.
Rachel Zale checking in for Courtney. And Peyton Weber checking in for Michaela. Peyton will go back to serve. Another great serve for Peyton. She's leading the team so far in serving aces with 63. Put in perspective, the national average is 12.
Right, that's fantastic. She had a heck of a streak against Holliston.
Yep.
Which I'm sure helped those numbers. A little trouble there getting that ball back over.
Rachel bumps it over. It's an outside set from Bellingham, handled by Jess. Peyton with a back set to Zale. And Rachel gets it through the block. Hillers take a one-point lead. Yeah, I don't think that I've seen Peyton put together less than at least three serve. Oh, curse of the announcer.
Curse of the announcer. You had it. You couldn't wait till after she hit the ball. Oh, that is the worst. And I hear about this afterwards when the girls watch the replay. They can hear. Yep.
Rachel with a set to Amanda. Amanda couldn't do much with that, just punch it over. There's a nice block from Ivy, kept alive by Bellingham. Peyton with an outside set to Rachel. Cross court kill. Nice swing from Rachel. Julia Canestrari checking in.
Maddie Madigani couldn't get under that one enough.
Amanda back to serve. Yep, a little miscommunication there from the Blackhawks. Five-three, Hillers in front. Nice serve from Amanda. Man, she's got all that one.
Yep. And then some.
Side out to Bellingham. Jenna Venuti back to serve. Jess handles that. Rachel with a short set.
Oh, nice.
Oh, nice dig. Nice save from Bellingham. Amanda to Peyton, outside to Zale. Nice block of the net from Bellingham, kept alive by Hopkinton.
Almost let that one go.
Outside set. Ivy had it, but yeah, ball was hit well.
Yeah, it rolled right in front of the block. But I'm going across net.
Bellingham within one. Jess handles that serve. Short set to Ivy. Nice put away. Side out to the Hillers. And Jill Sarapusco checks in. Jess back to serve. Let's see if the Hillers can take advantage of this. Another out. Thought it was going to be a short set.
Yeah,
they fooled me.
Too. They fooled everybody.
Jess to Peyton, short set, and then net violation. Jill's momentum carried her into the net. Rachel with a set outside to Julia. Nice put away from Julia. Michaela Pucci checking back in, as well as Courtney Hassan. Peyton and Rachel leave. And Courtney's back to serve. Hillers in front by two here early in the first set. That's nice block from Jill.
All by herself.
Another nice serve from Courtney. Oh, that looked like it caught the line.
Yep. Not enough of it, though.
Side out to Bellingham. That's wide. Good eyes from Michaela and Julia. They both kind of looked at each other. And Allison Lorette checks in. And she'll go back to serve. Allison floats one in. Outside set. And sent long.
It just pulled it here.
Yep, nice pullback from Jess. Courtney to Michaela, outside to Amanda. Nice put away from Amanda. Nice swing. Hillers opening up a 5-point lead here in the first set. And a nice serve. Jess to Courtney with a short set. Nice hit from Jill.
Nice and easy.
Timing was perfect on that. And Bellingham takes the timeout there. Coach, got to get him to print these bigger.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Mantegani
Mantegatti, Stephen Mantegatti.
Calls timeout as the Hillers have a 7-point lead.
We have Chip. There's Chip Collins down there. Chip Collins trying to push the sales of the raffles. They got some beautiful baskets, and this bicycle is something else. I wouldn't be surprised that during one of the timeouts he comes riding out on the court on that bike. So it's, and it's not too late to donate to this cause as well. If you go to the HCAM website, you'll see the story about the Dig Pink tournament match that we're having today, game match. And you can go there and go on the Hillers Side Up Foundation page and make a donation there.
Yeah, it was a good picture of the girls.
That was. They did a nice job. I like that, V.
And Allison will get us back underway. Oh, I thought Jill was going to take a free hit there. She just took a soft one. Michaela to Courtney, back to Michaela, and Pucci hit it into the net.
Yeah, nice block by Maddie Madagiani.
Shout out to the Blackhawks.
Nice dig.
Another one. Oh, they had a chance for a free hit, and they couldn't take advantage of it. Couldn't look at Courtney's reaction.
Sometimes those free hits aren't that good.
No.
Sometimes they're unexpected.
Jill Sarapuska back to serve. Oh.
Wow.
That one kind of crawled up and over the net. Point for the Hillers.
Eighth inch one way, would have been a side out.
Hopkinton with his largest lead of the evening.
It's a little close to the net.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice block from Jill. Or that was Ivy, I'm sorry.
That was Ivy. Yeah, the set was way too close to the net.
Yep. Bellingham having trouble receiving serve.
Aaron Umloft, the defensive specialist there, just shanked it.
And that sails long. Sat out Bellingham.
Hopkins doing a good job mixing up the serves again.
Yep. Yeah, I would say overall that the serving of this year's team is very, very good.
I mean, right from the
get-go. Usually it takes about 4 or 5 games for them to get into rhythm.
I'm going to boast to say this, and you can call me crazy, and I could be wrong, but this has probably been the best serving team that I've witnessed in my 10 years.
From you know, first player to last player, I would agree with you.
First player, last player, first game to today.
Yep. Rachel's checking in as well as Peyton.
I'm sure some of the alumni that are watching online right now are saying, no way, you're crazy.
Well,
Mr.
we are.
Oh, yeah, of course we're crazy. What do we know? We're just spectators that get to talk about it.
And nice serve from Peyton. The middle set. Jess handles that. Peyton with a short set to Ivy. Nice put away.
Amy Colho tried this armbar back into play, but no luck.
Hillers up 20-9. Nice serve. Allison with a bump to Peyton with back set to Rachel. And Rachel catches the top of the net, but still is able to power it over. Point to the Hillers. Twenty-one-9. Double hit.
Double hit. I can hear it in the headphones.
I was just going to say, you can. it's tougher to see, but you can hear it
right
when it's done incorrectly. Especially when you do it right in front of the up judge.
Yep.
And Bellingham shanks that one. And we've got Bellingham using its last time out of the first set. So the Hillers have their next home game next Wednesday, October 19th, as Westwood comes to town.
That should be an interesting game.
And do we have any scores that are coming in from?
I get nothing yet.
Nothing yet.
I'm still looking. Football is about 10 minutes away from their start.
Chip's going strong on selling the raffles.
Chip Collins is very entertaining here at the high school. Well-loved by the student body and definitely loved by the volleyball fans.
So the Hillers 2 points from closing out this first set. Peyton will get us back underway. Another nice deep serve from Peyton. And Bellingham couldn't get that over. So set point. I think an ace to end the first set would be appropriate here for Peyton. A nice dig from Bellingham, and there's a double hit. It's a point to the Hillers, so that's the first set. Hillers take it 25-9. The girls are going to switch sides, and we'll be back after a short break.
Are you worried about letting your child take the wheel? Maybe you should also be worried about what you're doing behind the wheel. A quick text, just this once, well, that might turn into a catastrophic accident. Monkey see what monkey do. If you do it, why wouldn't your child? In a child's brain, almost all things their parents do, they can do too. 78% of teen drivers surveyed text and drive. 59% said their parents do it too. Stop texting and driving, because if you do it, your child will too.
And we're back for set number two.
And look at the beautiful decorations.
The gym does look good.
They do a nice job. They get the balloons everywhere. There are a few less balloons on this side. I had to make them take it down because it was in the way of the cameras.
So what do we have for stats there from the first set, Mike?
Well, it was nice of them to run them over to us. In the dig department, looks like Jess leads with two. Amanda and Michaela both have one. As far as assists go, Peyton goes with five. Courtney with two. Michaela and Rachel both had one. And two's a wild in the aces with Amanda, Jill, and Peyton. And in the kill department, we have a bunch of threes. Three kills for Rachel, Ivy, and Amanda, followed by Jill with two. And Courtney and Julia both had one apiece.
So out there on the floor for the Hillers, we've got back row of Jill, Peyton, and Brooke is making her debut after being out for a while. And then we've got Amanda, Rachel, and Julia at the net. I'm just getting ready to check in, most likely for Jill.
Well, this just in, talking about other scores. The eighth grade field hockey team beat Wellesley 3-0 with goals from Leela Frederick, Alyssa Souza, with an assist from Rachel Bachman, and Megan Muldoon with an assist from Alyssa Souza. The team continues to show their talent and sharp skills, both offensively and defensively.
And Peyton's going to get the second set underway, picking up where she left off at the end of the first set. Bellingham bumps it over. Jess to Peyton with a short set to Julia. Nice put away. Bellingham was able to get a hand on it for a block, but Julia hit it hard enough to get it through. Hillers take the first point of the second set. And Peyton sends that one long. Side out to the Blackhawks. Callie McGregor serving. Jess handles that. Rachel with an outside set to Amanda. Nice put away. Another nice kill from Amanda. She's leading the team in kills with 92 so far. Put that in perspective, the national average for the person leading a team is 41. And Amanda has a nice serve. Oh, nice, nice get from Amanda. Kept that alive. And, Bellingham almost.
So close.
Julia took a quick hit.
Amy Colho tried to armbar that back and just spun off her hand.
Hillers in front, 3-1. Nice knuckleball serve. And Bellingham cranks that one over. That was deep, deep, deep in the hole. And, Rachel with a great hit, kept alive.
And over the other side of the center.
It was a very nice swing from Rachel. Jess gets to that one. Peyton to Zale. Great block at the net. That was a great block from Bellingham, side out.
That was Gabby Palazulos. That was a stiff block.
Yep. Jenna Venuti serving and puts that one into the net. Because Rachel swung. That shot had venom on it, and it was a great block.
I did not see her abs get pushed back on the block. It was solid.
Julia back to serve. Point to the Hillers. I think we might have had that. We might have had a scoreboard hit there had the big old box still been here. And Bellingham's going to have to work for this one. Nope. Falls a wee bit short. Just wide. Hillers in front by 6 now. In front by 7. Let's see if the coach takes the timeout here. Nope. He's going to let the girls keep going.
Yep.
It's going to be tough to get to. Nice job. Bellingham keeps that alive. Blocked at the net. Peyton outside to Zale. Rachel's timing was off on that.
I don't know if you can see it because the ref's more in your way, but that one just cleared the net.
Ooh, that was sailing long. Bellingham kept it in. And there's the call for a timeout at the nine-point break.
Points, yeah.
It's usually 6, 7, or 8.
Yeah, eight was always the go. And then early on it was 6. But we'll take the 8. So other scores from around the high school, The golf team was defeated by Medway, 243-260. But the boys' soccer team beat Norton 2-0.
Oh, wow. That's a upset.
Yeah. They were up 1-0 at the halftime, and before the end, the last score that I get was 2-0.
I fully expected to see Chip out here riding the bike again.
No, it looks like he's tweeting right now. He's trying to tweet some ticket sales.
So the Hill is in front, 11-2, here on Dig Pink Night. The colors that you're seeing on your television screens are correct. And Julia Canestrari gets us back in action. Short serve. Peyton to Zale, outside. Oh! Set went a little long, or Ivy ran a little too far. Side out Bellingham. Jess checks back in.
Well, I just tweeted Chip Collins riding that bicycle, and Chip Collins liked it. He even retweeted it. Thank you, Chip, for keeping the support of HKM's Twitter. Nice spin.
And providing some comic amusement.
Wow.
Hiller's with a little trouble handling that serve.
Yeah, there's a vicious. Watch the spin that.
Is that Mackenzie
Boucher? No, this is Sonny Nelson, number 28. That's an 8, believe it or not.
How come I don't have a 28 on mine?
She wears two numbers.
Ah.
Oh, so
oh,
she's
yeah.
Probably the other libero. That's why she has a 15 for white shirt.
Side out to the Hillers. Rachel Zale serving. And a miscommunication. And under the bleachers.
Under the bleachers. Get the other ball.
And nice serve from Rachel. Hillers in front by 10. Amanda outside to Pucci. Nice cross-court kill. Oh, nice try from Bellingham.
Yeah, it's always good effort when you can try to play it around the bench.
Yep. Nice serve from Zale. What an ace.
Yeah, that was a big, long campfire. As I went by, three people just looked at it.
That was a great serve. Let's see if she can repeat it. Nice get from Rachel. Outside set to Ivy.
Oh.
I think Ivy gets this year's smile award, too. She's always got a smile on her face.
Yeah, no matter what happens, whether it's good or bad, she's got that smile.
Outside set to the Blackhawks. Nice cross-court hit. Kept alive by Amanda. Ivy bumps it over. It's a middle set. And hit wide. And Zale strung together a nice set of serves here. Close in front, 19-4. Nice dig from the libero. Fortunately, that one got yanked a little long.
You know, it its disappearance, and here's Bellingham's second timeout, which I think they needed about 2 points ago.
Yep, just to get the girls to calm down a little bit.
You see, it looks like they're just hitting the ball away. Oh, we get something from Mr. Collins over there.
Probably in about six more points in between the second and third set. So make sure you have all your tickets purchased because we're going to be raffling them off. Unfortunately, I rolled home with a bike already, so sorry.
All right. Nice little interaction with Mr. Collins. He's getting used to the television cameras and looking for cues from us.
Yeah.
You might have to put him on the end credits, too, as part of the talent.
He's given enough plugs tonight.
Yeah, so. as we're saying, it looks like Bellingham's just hitting the ball away, and there's no placement. They have a difficulty setting, and yep. Then they're just hitting it just to hope it goes on the other side so they can regroup.
Yep, they're having trouble with the receiving of the serve.
Exactly.
And they've kept that one alive. There's Ivy with a bump. Rachel, the back set to Pucci. And Pucci with a punch. That was a great swing.
That was well announced, and you knew it was going to be coming hard at you.
To 4. Hillers in front late in the second set.
I just rolled
the
up
point for the Hillers. And at the conclusion of the set, normally we take a break and let the girls change sides, but we're going to stay live with the
Raffles. Absolutely. We'll get to see who's winning, get to see all the cool stuff that they have. The baskets are amazing.
Yep. Side out to the Blackhawks.
And I might as well give a little plug to our friends of the Hopkinton Seniors. They're going to be doing their silent auction come November 2nd to December 1st, or November 1st to December 2nd, something like that. Throughout the whole month, you go down to the Senior Center, and they have these gift baskets, which are amazing. They got them for everybody. They got them for kids. They got them for sports fans, movie fans. Fantastic items. They even got a couple hockey sticks signed by the Bruins. So go down to the Senior Center, stop in, and put a bid out. All that money, the Friends of the Seniors support the transportation program. They fund all of it and then some.
Oh. Ivy didn't get much on that, but it was just enough.
Just enough.
Just enough to coax it over. And Brooke's going to check in. She'll go back to serve. So Brooke's been out for a few weeks with a concussion.
Yeah, they take that very seriously now, the testing protocols to get back to play. You just can't say, yeah, I feel all right.
It's Courtney with a nice second hit from Jenna Wilworth. So we're 1 point away from the second set. The Hillers took the first set. And they're a point away from closing out the second set and getting us on to the raffle here at annual Dig Pink night. Great serve from Brooke, and that will do it. The Hillers take the second set, 25-5. And we're going to stay live for the winners of the raffle.
If they ever get out there. And we'll just wait for Mr. Collins over there. All right, here he comes.
He was probably retweeting.
Yeah.
Did anybody buy the raffle tickets? Because it is time to pull some tickets to see who wins what. I need some help, though, ladies. Who's going to help me out here? All right, let's start off with the spike ball. We're going to go right down the line. Come on out here. Come on out here. Smiles and all. Let's go here. You're going to reach your hand in there. It's for the spike ball donated by Coach. You have a ticket. And then the winner is?
Amanda Gilbert.
Amanda Gilbert gets the spike ball, yeah. All right, there we go.
There you go, one of the players. Yeah, she's going to come and get it. We'll get her on the camera, too.
What's the next one we have here? What's our next one? All right, we're going to go on to the, take your time. Sure. All right, let's see here. What do we have here? A day at the beach. Let's see here, day at the beach. Rolling coolers, water jug. There's a whole host of stuff in this one. Wow. Let me just tell you, there's a lot of stuff in here. Total value of $175. And the winner is?
Angie Grabbeye and selected this one.
Four. There's a four on the back. Jay. Let's read the number. Number 1, 3, 4, 6, 2, 1.
Here we go, up here in the audience.
And we have a winner.
Where are your tickets? Did you bring your tickets with you?
The boss has them.
Oh, the boss has them.
Hello, Bella. How are you? How's your season going? Great. So what do we have here now? The Hiller Spirit one. And you're full of spirit, so why don't you pull this ticket for me? No cheating. There's no name. All right. Let's read the number.
1, 3, 4, 0, 4, 1.
And the Zale family going all home right with a basket.
What's the next one? The gift card basket. This is a fantastic, the gift card basket. Let me just tell you, a lot of tickets sold here. What's your name?
Serena.
Serena, nice to meet you.
Kim Manning.
Kim Manning.
Oh, the Manning
gift card
house
basket.
They were here. They're down on the floor.
Kim and Mike Manning.
Come on out. Come on out. All right, the next one is the pink basket.
Oh, this is fun.
Well, how are you? What's your name?
Maddie.
Maddie what?
Strickland.
Maddie Strickland, nice to meet you. Are you ready? You look nervous. All right, smile. Here we go. For the pink basket.
I don't know. Oh, Diane Nelson.
Diane Nelson?
Yeah. Over here on the Bellingham side.
Here we go. Very good. For the pink basket. Very good.
Oh, here we go.
I hear the various.
Well, thank you very much. I already won, so thank you. Thank you very much. Well, yes, the pink bike is now here. Let's see who wins. Bella? Bella, you want to make sure it has a double C on the back.
Well, thanks.
Remember, it's all about playing time. Playing time. Bridget Lee. You have to be here to claim it. Only kidding.
The
only
big
kidding
prize if she's not here. I love all the bubble gum.
Look at all the tickets the coaches have.
It's unbelievable, yeah. I think they just all throw them away now. They wanted that big bike.
Mary and Margie had a fist wad full of tickets there.
Everyone's heartbroken on not winning that bicycle.
I'm a little upset. I was looking forward to riding home.
I already asked. They don't want to come up and join us.
No, don't blame them.
I thought this announcing stuff ran in the family.
No.
Oh, speaking
of... Oh, Emma will do it.
Speaking about family...
Oh, there's Peter.
There's Peter Bransfield. The man who started it all. Well, he was a boy who started it all. Now he's a man. We'll see if we can get him up here to visit the booth.
And we're back for set number three. Hillers took the first two sets. Out there on the floor for the girls, we've got Jenna, Jill, and Peyton in the back with Julia and Rachel, and we're short a player. Jess is waiting to check in as the libero.
Yeah, usually they have the sixth player out there and then they just swap, but... I don't think they're going to be playing down one.
And even Coach Grabmeier is confused.
And just, it's just something don't look right. Is it Ivy? Is it? No, it is.
Brooke. Brooke. Okay, so Jenna's going to move up to the net.
There you go.
Okay. Now we're unconfused.
There you go. So I got a few stats from, I know all the excitement's over from the raffle, but we do have some stats.
Oh, we got some real stuff to talk about?
Yeah. Dig department, Jess with two, Amanda with one. For the kills, Michaela led with three. And Amanda, Jenna, Julia, Ivy, and Rachel all had one apiece.
And Jess is leading the team in digs with 145 today.
Which we don't have. Yeah, we don't have... I'd like to see the blocks.
I would, too.
With the assist, two assists by Peyton. And for aces, Rachel with three and Julia with one.
In the blocks department, they've got Jill Sarapusco listed with 22 so far, which is double the national average. Shout out to the Hillers. Ivy will check in. And Jenna Wilworth goes back to serve. And there's a little quick bump over with an outside set to Gilbert. And she puts that one away. Or no, sorry, that was Ivy.
It was Ivy? Yep.
Yep. Yeah, I think Amanda's done for the night. She's sitting. Jenna's taking her place in the rotation.
Nice arm.
Nice. Oh, nice.
Oh,
great hustle from Bellingham.
Yeah, that's Amy Colehall.
Great hustle.
I think I'm not butchering that one too much. I'm going to talk to D. King about phonetic rosters for next year.
Make it a league mandate.
Sometimes we don't have time to talk to the coaches
right
ahead of time.
Yep. That in bigger fonts.
Bigger fonts.
There's Peyton with a back set to Zale. Nice swing from Rachel. Good put away.
Yeah. Eddie Mitigani tried to go at it, but it was just too far. She found the opener.
Man, that sails long.
That was a hard serve.
And Allison checks in for Jenna.
I
Kaylee McGregor back to serve. Allison receives that. Short set to Julia. Net violation. Julia hit it on her follow through. Her shoulder caught the net. Jess receives that. Rachel. Back row hit from Peyton. Beautiful hit. Timed that one perfectly. And Julia back to serve. Hiller's in front by three here in the third set. Hopkinton took the first two sets in this best of five. Oh, nice little quick back hit.
Yeah, that was a nice break. I mean, she tried that a couple times earlier. That was the first one that actually worked.
Yeah. The other time she did, the ball was higher, so you had a little bit more time to react. This one, the ball was a lot lower.
Yeah, and Allison just going to get a finger on it.
Jenna Venuti back to serve for the Blackhawks. I think that was sailing long. Allison kept it in play. Jess with a bump over. See if the Hillers can take advantage of this. Short set. Oh. Jill's timing was off on that one. Bellingham within one. Jess, Rachel, a little miss hit on the set, but kept alive. There's a nice put away. That was Maddie Mantegani.
That was one of the better ones that they've done today.
Yep. So we're tied up at five. Allison, oh, Rachel with a quick put over. Nice, smart play. She saw the big hole and just did a quick bump over the net. Pucci checks in and Zale back to serve. Now Rachel goes down the line. And once again, another little backhanded flap.
I'm guessing it's something they practice because
I'm not a big fan of it, but.
Well, I mean, once in a while you can toss it over, but that, I mean, it's being hit with a mission. It's not being just like, because usually the softer little dinks are the ones that are your point scorers.
Allison to Rachel with a short set to Jill. Got that one over.
Oh,
nice point to the Hillers.
Duncan getting a little frazzled there.
Oh, that thing died at the end. Great serve from Rachel. There's Jess to Rachel. Back set to Pucci. Kept alive by Bellingham. Allison to Rachel to Jill. Nice put away. Just a soft touch to the far side.
Tell you, every game, more and more, we get impressed by the ball placement of the Hiller team.
And that's something this team seems to do more than the teams since I can remember, is not necessarily hitting the ball hard, but placing the ball.
Right. Yeah, it's not, I mean, because we've seen plenty of power spikers over the years that can really nail the ball. But we're not talking about pure spiking.
Right.
We're just talking about ball placement.
Just like that hit Ivy just had. Yep. It was a nice, strong swing, but it didn't have a lot of power, but it was just placed perfectly. And there's a timeout from Bellingham, the first timeout of the set. You're allowed two per set.
At the 6 point.
Maybe you heard us.
Maybe it was something we said.
As I said earlier, the girls have their next home game next Wednesday, October 19th at 6:30 as Westwood comes to town. Hillers defeated Westwood 3-0 in the first meeting at Westwood. And then they've got the M's coming up after that. And they've got a trip to Frontier thrown in there, too. So that'll be a good test for the girls as they go to perennial Division III powerhouse.
This just in from David Hughes Stadium. Connor Hebert with the touchdown. Hillers complete the conversion and go up 8-0.
Beautiful night to be outside.
I think so, yeah. It's not raw like the past nights. I'd love to go visit that game right after, but I got to get back to work.
In your pink shirt?
In my pink shirt, absolutely.
So Hiller's in front by 6. Rachel will get us back underway. Oh, nice get from Ivy. That's going to be tough. Ah, a little net violation there.
Yeah. Oh, tough.
Yeah, Bellingham hit the net first.
Yep.
Michaela hit it, but it was after Bellingham hit it. Twelve-5. Hiller's in front. Oh, just punched wide by Michaela.
Yeah, they're over the net.
Courtney checks in for Rachel. Still checking the rotation here. And we're ready to go. Mackenzie Boucher. Nope, that's...
Sonny Nelson.
Yep, nope, Sonny Nelson, Sonny 28. Nelson. Side out to the Hillers. Brooke checks in. She'll go back to serve. And... Jenna checks in as well. 13-6. Outside set. And that's just long from the Blackhawks.
I'll go grab that ball when I'm on my way back to Ashland.
Yep. Oh, Jill took advantage of that free hit, kept alive. There's a miscommunication there. It looked like it was supposed to be a short set. Courtney forgot.
Yeah, she kind of...
just did a little forehead smack.
Yeah, saying, oops, yeah, wrong one. My bad.
Side out to the Blackhawks.
You know, we can laugh at it now, but it's those kind of mistakes that...
Rotation violation on the Hillers.
It's those kind of mistakes that usually cost points at the critical times, and they have not made those kind of mistakes.
Hillers in front by 6.
Nope.
Again.
Offsides. What,
in the serve receive.
I think she just put a foot over the line.
Now, this is something you don't expect to see at this time of the year, especially from veterans. Allison. To Courtney, outside to Jenna. Nice hit from Jenna. Nice swing down the line. Julia checks in. And Jess back to serve. And Pucci with a nice hit, kept alive. Oh. Couldn't get the third hit on it. Point to the Hillers. J Jess to Courtney with a short set. Julia with a great swing. That was perfect.
That was
almost straight down. And Jess sends that one into the net, side out to Bellingham. Goes in front by 7. Oop.
Nice recovery.
Yeah, just couldn't control that, but Pucci kept it alive. There's a set to the middle hitter. Great block, and there it is. Julia with putting the roof on it. Rachel for Courtney. And Peyton for Michaela.
I know, I was smelling a timeout coming from Bellingham, but I just saw them sit back and cross their legs. So I think
the body language gave it away.
Out.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see it letting them play out.
Peyton to serve. Hiller's up by 8. Peyton with a back set to Zale, and she swoops in for the kill.
I think Bellingham just wants to go home.
Getting a little encouragement from their crowd.
Yeah, the parents are still with them.
And another nice put away from Julia in the middle. Took advantage of the free hit. That's what you want to do, is capitalize on the other team's mistakes.
Right.
And there's the timeout. Guess they didn't want to go home that quick.
Either that or he's been listening to our broadcast online, which everyone can watch on HKIV TV's live stream. We stream both television, HKIV TV and HKIV Ed. You can also watch us on Comcast 8. In 30 for HKIV TV and Verizon 30 and 30. I'm sorry. It's Comcast 8, Verizon 30 for HKIV TV. I got it right in front of me and I can't even read it right. And HKIV Ed, Comcast 96, Verizon 31.
So the Hillers took the first two sets and they're up by 10 here late in the third set.
I was hoping to get a couple words from Peter Bransfield, but he's down there talking to his dad.
And Peyton will get us back underway. Oh, good recovery from Jenna. Oh.
And may have an injury.
Yeah, I think she hit her head.
That's Mackenzie Boucher. And we'll let the athletic trainer work on her. Oh, she smashed her nose on the floor. But we'll let them work on it and we'll... And she makes her way up. A round of applause from everybody. Love to see them get up, walk it on their own accord. And she'll take a rest of the... Looks like the trainer will take care of her. I believe, is that Mara? Mara White?
Twenty-one 10, and Peyton with a bullet for a serve. Jess handles that. Peyton with an outside set to Jenna, and Jenna hit that one into net. Side out to the Blackhawks.
Nice block by Haley DeRocious, who is on her way up.
And Casey Baker serving for Bellingham. 21-11, Bellingham down by 10. And serve into the net, side out to the Hillers. Hellison and Ivy will check in. Allison will go back to serve. Middle set to the Blackhawks. Hit that one into the net. Point to the Hillers. We're 2 points away from ending this match. Once again, on this annual Dig Pink Breast Cancer Research Fundraiser night. Very good turnout. Jess handles that. Peyton with a back set to Zale. Great dig from Bellingham. And a double hit. 24 to 11.
Looked like that was going to be one of their better rallies, too.
And that'll do it, folks. The Hillers take this third set 25 to 11 for a 3-0 sweep of the Blackhawks. The girls are going to shake hands.
And before I forget, I have to mention our crew. I can't believe I had not mentioned our crew. Skeleton crew again tonight. Running the controls. Tom Diggs directing. Samantha with all the score changes and all the beautiful graphics. And making his debut on camera number two is Declan Curry, who did a heck of a job. I got to watch him on it a few times. And, man, can he follow the ball. Thanks for coming along tonight, Declan.
So the girls' next home game is next Wednesday. Westwood comes to town. We encourage everybody to come down and support the Hillers. So for Mike Tarosian, this is Steve Sweetapple, and we'll see you in a few nights.